Hey everyone, this is Johnnyonoes and I'm playing My Summer Car, and in this Let's Learn episode, I'm going to show you all the different locations on the map. Alright, I'm pretty sure you're all very familiar with the house, but I want to be pretty comprehensive. So there's a ton of amenities. Actually, almost all the amenities are here at your home, which is where you can build up your urine or bring down your urine, hunger, thirst, fatigue, dirtiness, and all that good stuff. So when you start the game, you start about right here. So straight ahead is your room, where you have the ability to go to sleep here on this bed. And there is also the magazine, which allows you to purchase all the different parts for your car. To select what you need to purchase your car, you just click on the little numbers. And then it will list out all of the items that you're purchasing. Click on Tillenyet! And you'll get yourself an envelope, which you can then take over to the shop and then get your parts ordered. There's also some fuzzy dice, if you want some fuzzy dice on inside your car. There's also a little radio, so you get some tunage going. Nice. Hit F to turn this thing on. You can bring some Muzak with you when you're building your car. Then you have the phone over here, which is where you receive most of your jobs. And if the phone is ringing nonstop and it's driving you completely apeshit, just go ahead and just turn the phone off by pulling the cord. Then you have your map, which is very useful because this is the only map in the whole game. So this will show you all the different locations, and as well as make sure to check out the link in the description below, where I will have the image that I made with all the different locations listed off of like Imgur or something like that. I'll find some share. This also gives you some information on the rally car race, which happens on Saturday and starts at 10 in the morning. And it starts right there and ends right once you get into town. So there's also a TV in here, which may not seem all that useful to you. But if you're watching TV at night, your fatigue will go down considerably, which is really useful if, like, you woke up in the middle of the night, you may be too scared, or you may not have anything to do while driving around. Make sure to turn the TV on, and your fatigue will go up considerably, allowing you to sleep a lot faster. There's a couple other rooms in here. There's like maybe his mom's room? I don't know. But there doesn't seem to be anything in here, unless there's something hidden. Very strange, nondescript closet. So that's, I guess, his mom's room? I don't know. Can't tell. Alright, that's all for this main room. Then inside here, you've got, you got your kitchen table. You can drink from the water spigot if you're not familiar with that. So you can drink and build up urine if you want to get some urine-related quests or achievements done. It's also a little fridge to throw your food into. That's your thing. I tend to pile them into the fridge because I don't like all the food on the ground. If you open this door, it's just a weird, strange brick and plaster room with what looks like AstroTurf on the floor. I don't think there's anything going on in here. And if you make your way to the back, there's a laundry room. Nothing going on in this room. But this room is kind of like a shower area that you can't actually get clean on. Like, turn the water on. Yeah, it'd be really nice if you just get clean by using the shower, but instead, what you're going to do is you're going to use the bucket, fill that up, and once the sauna is hot, you'll be able to use the sauna to get rid of your dirtiness level. Now, here is the sauna. There is a nice, appropriate depiction of how hot it is, depending on how high the guy's dong is at. And you have your little oven right here. There's two dials. The dial on the left depicts how hot you want it. So really just scroll up as much as you can until it stops. And then the timer will be how long the oven is on for. And you'll get this really annoying buzzing sound throughout your whole house. So the idea is, normally, you're going to want to raise the thermostat up as high as you can, and then turn the timer all the way to the right. It takes about a full day for this sauna to heat up. So this should be one of the first things you do when you log into the game. get yourself the sauna going, and that way every time you need to reduce your dirtiness, it's all ready for you. Here's the backyard, and that's pretty much the house. That's everything that you can find in the house. Let's go on over to the garage. All right, here's the garage where you've got yourself a trash can for all your empty bottles. The back seats are listed in the front here, or are sitting here on the front. You got a little basketball hoop as well. I think there's a basketball somewhere in the house. I think it could be, I think it's in your room. Let's see. No, there's a basketball somewhere, but we'll find it. All right, so here's your garage where most of your work is going to happen here. You have a pit on the ground, inside the ground here, where the exhaust pipe is at. Exhaust pipe may not be clear to most folks, but that's where the exhaust pipe is at. And you got your suspension stuff here. You got your paneling over on the side. And then you have all of your engine-related equipment right on the far side of the garage, as well as some tires. Make sure to grab this gasoline tank first and foremost when you make your first trip over to the shop, so you get some fuel for your car. And make sure to head into the bathroom to save your game. So basically all the amenities are here in the house. Right across from your house, you're going to see a little dirt path. If you follow it, you'll be able to get to the boat. The boat will allow you to get to two different locations. There's a cabin in the middle of the lake, as well as going, being able to go all the way to town as well. So if you're going to do something simple like bring in an envelope to get mailed, you can always use the boat to get head on over there. Or if you just want to sit and relax, head on over to the cabin, get some old school type of sauna going, and relax the day away. All right, so over at the farm, when you first start the game, you're going to see your poop truck here. This is where you initially get your poop truck. There is a little wood chopping area here with your axe, some wood to chop, as well as a beautiful bottle of what looks like, I guess, vodka. You drink this, you're going to be really tripping out. So if you want to knock yourself out, go for that type of drink. On the other side of the barn, there is the diesel jerry can, very useful for filling up the tractor from time to time. A full jerry can of diesel will give you about a half a tank on the tractor. Don't bother using the jerry can on the truck, because the poop truck is the poop truck. The jerry can is like a sliver of gasoline on the poop truck, so don't even bother. Really use it mostly for the tractor or the van if it's low on gas. You also have your flatbed here, which you can connect to the tractor and move some stuff around. Then you have yourself a porta potty here, where you can save the game. All right, here is the store, which has a bunch of different amenities in it. First off, you have the gas tanks, you have the diesel, you have the 98. So the diesel is going to be for your larger trucks, where the poop truck, you've got the tractor, as well as your van. And then the 98 octane will be for the Fellendale and the in your regular car here that you've built. There is also a porta potty in the back. So if you wanted to get ready for race day, which is what this current save that I'm on right now, you can save the game, start here instead of having to drive all the way back from home if you're driving the rally car race. The mailbox is out front, so if you have an envelope filled with your orders of all the cool things you can buy for your car, make sure to put the envelope up in the front. As you put the envelope in, this will open up, and then if you do it right, the envelope will disappear. Then after maybe half a day or a whole day, come on back and you'll be able to go ahead and pay for your delivery, and all of it will just appear right over on the side here. All right, walking on in, you got the asshole in the yellow car. Another YouTuber had actually killed this guy by hitting him with the poop truck at like 100 km per hour. So if you want to wreck his day, just hit him with the poop truck. All right, inside the shop, you're going to have your little friend here with the crazy eyes. Look at those eyes. They follow you. They follow you. How far can he turn his head? Let's see. Let's see how far he can turn his head. All right, that's as far. Good 90 degrees. All right, so on the far left of the shop, you're going to see your brake fluid, your motor oil, your coolant. In the beginning of the game, before you build your car, the fan belt's going to be right here as well. There's some ingredients up in the front here. It looks like for, I'm guessing, for making the Cujo, I think it's called. I'm probably butchering the pronunciation for it, but I think this is all the materials for making your own liquor that I guess is going to go in the next update or so. Then you have your mosquito spray over here. You've got your little vending machine. Not vending machine. This is like a slot machine here. You can make some... You can't make a lot of money off of it. I think like the most you can make off of it is like 400 or 500. But there's the gambling machine. The slot machine. I don't know why that word's not coming to me. You can get some milk over here on the side. Milk will lower your hunger and thirst. So if you get a lot of milk, you can drink that. But who drinks milk around here when you can get yourself a nice case of beer, which will lower your thirst, obviously. You get some chips and also other various food items. Chips, obviously, will raise your thirst up quite a bit and reduce your hunger to a certain amount. The best ones, of course, are the sausages, which will basically clear out a full bar of hunger and just give you a little bit of thirst. But that is the shop. All right, so the inspection station place. Mechanic. Well, he's not really a mechanic. He just inspects your car to make sure that everything is screwed in properly and put together properly. It's a great place to, once you're done with your car, get it checked to see if you did everything correct. But all you have to do is drive your car right up on the lift here and head on inside the office and give this guy some money. Well, it looks like you're going to have to put your car on the lift to get that option. Let me do that right now. Yeah, so once you got your car on the lift, you can then go ahead and call for an inspection. I've already inspected my car, so it looks like that option is not here. But if you select him, it's another one of those creepy faces. You can just go ahead and select him and have him inspect your car. He'll give you a little readout on how you did. And if you pass, he'll give you some license plates put on your car. The graveyard is a decent little place to find out how many times you've died in the game. This is a relatively new save that I'm using right now, but if I was playing this legit, this whole place would probably be completely covered with Oh No's Johnny. Yeah. That's pretty much what you would see. So easy to die. There's also a plaque over on the other side here for some of the, I guess, the playtesters or the, the playtesters. Lots of Johnnies. There's four Johnnies. All right. So the main bus stop is going to be right across from the store. This allows you to jump on the bus, pay for a ticket, and get sent around the map while on the bus. There are four bus stops on the main street. They're depicted by this kind of like a deceleration lane or outlet here, as well as either a bench or just a sign that has a bus icon on it. So if you want the bus to stop, go ahead and stick your thumb out and wait for the bus to come on by, and he will stop here and pick you up. The bus does not stop at each of these stops unless you either tell him to while you're on the bus or you're sitting outside here with your thumb sticking up. All right, so here is the airport, which allows you to do a little bit of a drag race. And it will time what's your acceleration per quarter mile, as well as your top speed on your car, if you can get it that far within the quarter mile. Then you can go ahead and check your speed with the guy that's over here. It gives you some stats on how well your car is driving on the street. So if you're going to go for, like, if you really want to make these numbers huge, then you really want to go with, like, the largest of the top gears. I think it's, like, the final gears. Then it's, like, 4.8 or something like that. And then make sure you have some racing tires on. Over on the southwest side of the airfield, you'll find the garbage dump, which at initial glance is pretty pointless, but it actually provides two important functions for you in the game. The first function is the fact that any objects in the game that fall through the world or disappear completely are going to appear right next to this little porta potty here. The other thing is that there is there's a little couch here now, which allows you to sleep. So this is another place that you can sleep that is, I don't remember it being knocked over like that, but yeah, you have the option of sleeping here. That's like, there's like three places that you can sleep in the game, or actually four places. So there's a home, there's the cabin here, and then anywhere you put your poop truck. So this is a great spot that if you want to rest up for the night, and there is a porta potty here too, so you can save the game. So this actually acts as a pretty decent save game spot for if you're saving before the rally race. So really nice and useful. And as I said before, any objects that fall through the world and disappear are going to appear in this location here. So every Saturday at 10 in the morning, you'll be given the treat of being able to participate in a little rally time trial. This is a great way to make 5,000. That's actually the only fun thing to do in the game to make some money. So make sure you got all the parts required for your car, such as the racing harness and the bucket seat, the rally tires. Make sure you have everything inspected by the inspector, as well as the roll cage, and you'll be able to participate in a rally race. Off on the southwest corner of the map, there is a little kind of like a dirt track that you can use to play around with your rally car tires. It's a very little track, not a lot going on it, but it's kind of a fun place to kind of learn how to use your parking brake or handbrake to throw the car around a little bit. Whee! A little tiny track, and the wreck 3 is over here as well. A little small wreck that you can make for, like, you can bring into the mechanic for about 2,000. But yeah, it's a great place to learn how to use the handbrake to throw the car from side to side. If you take your boat for a ride, you can head on over to a cabin that was just implemented recently. It's on the little island in the middle of the lake between your house dock and town. Alright, so the cabin is sitting nicely on this little island. I went and looked around all the island, and I didn't see anything else other than this cabin. It also has a place for you to save, so you can save, you can sleep, and you can get rid of your dirtiness here too. So you can sleep on the little couch or a futon that's here. There's nothing else in this little room except for this little lantern, which you can pick up and use as a secondary source of light. It's actually it's a lot nicer than the flashlight because it covers light all the way around. So if you needed a little bit of light in your garage, this is a great thing to pick up. Keep things all nice and lit. And inside here, you got a little old-timey type of stove in here, which when you open it up and you go chop some wood, I think it can hold about 4 logs of wood. So you can grab your axe, chop your own wood for a little bit of old school sauna action. You just throw some wood in here, you light it, and it will slowly heat up the sauna. So you can go ahead and do your sauna. Also, there's no faucet in this cabin, so the way you get water is you just bring the bucket over and just dunk it in the lake here, and it'll be filled up. There you go. It's actually really fast. It's nice. So you just use the sun as you would normally. But the cabin is a nice little addition that was added. You know, I would imagine it's a great place to, if you're going back and forth with the boat a lot and your fatigue is getting high, your dirtiness is really high, great place to stop by just to relax. What I tend to do in the late game is that I'll bring some food over here too, so it makes for a pretty decent pit stop. All right, the mechanic is on the northeast side of the map. He's got quite a few amenities here, as well as providing all sorts of different services for you and your car. So you just want to make sure that you head on over here at 8 in the morning. And it's got to be during the week. Like, you won't be able to get into his shop during the weekend, and his hours are 8 to 4 p.m. But here he is. What's on my mind, young man? So all the different options he gives you are very important in the sense that, this first page may not be that important if you know what you're doing in terms of calibration. Like, if you know how to do the wheel alignment, the brake check and repair, engine repair, all this stuff. Jesus, shut up. You done talking? Thanks, man. I'd like to explain what kind of services you're providing, right? Alright, so this first page is all about kind of repairing stuff, as well as a couple adjustments that you can make yourself. So wheel alignment, the motor tuning, as well as, motor tuning and wheel alignment. Those are the things that you can do yourself. Everything else is if something goes terribly wrong. So like if your engine goes on fire, you can get your engine repaired. And your windshield is something that breaks all the time, so that's something that needs to be replaced here too. The roll cage for the rally racing is also here. You also have you can calibrate your final gear change here. So basically the way this works is the factory setting that you start the game off with is 4.286. The higher you go, the higher top speed you'll have, but the slower acceleration that you'll have. So if you want to do really well with the drag race, you want to go with 4.6. If you want to do really well with the rally racing, 3.7, 3.9 is the way to go. I personally set it at 3.9. I felt that 3.7, I kept like trying to figure out which gear I needed to be at while driving the rally race. So 3.9 fits really nicely with the type of way I drive. Then you have the ability to clean up all the rust on each of the parts of your car. When it's all said and done, your car looks super shiny without all that rust on it. Almost too shiny, actually, but it looks a lot nicer than when you first start the game out. Then you have the option of putting in some like paint jobs, like metallic looking paint jobs. You can also, if you've got a screenshot or a picture that you'd like to just kind of imprint on your car, you can do it by clicking on this guy here. Then you have some polishing to the rims and some coloring to the rims as well. Those are all the services that are provided by the mechanic. There is also a Fellendale here, which is like an American muscle car. So if you bring your car in to get repaired, it's going to basically take maybe half a day for him to fix all the stuff that you've asked him to. To get home, you can just go ahead and use the Fellendale to be able to get home. He basically says, go ahead and take the car to get home. What I tend to do, though, is I like bringing my van over here, because the van, I feel like the van's a lot easier to drive than the Fellendale. There's also a porta potty over on the right-hand side if you want to save the game. If you happen to be hanging out at home at night, you'll eventually get a call from a guy that has stranded himself next to the shop. If you drive on over there, just head on over to the bus stop that's right across from the shop, and you'll pick him up and he'll jump in your car. The poor schmuck has drunken himself to oblivion, so it's up to you to bring him over to his house on the eastern side of the map. All right, once you park right in front of his house, it's got a little bit of a white picket fence out there. He'll go ahead, thanks for dropping me off, and then he'll hand you like a good 300, 400 marks worth of cash. And you drop him off. As soon as he gets out of your car, he's going to then finally succumb to his drunkenness and mission complete. All right, so the place to deliver all the firewood is also on the eastern side of the map, southeastern side of the map. All you gotta do is drive your tractor filled with all sorts of goodies and firewood back there. park it right next to his driveway, and then go ahead and use the rear hydraulics to lift the flatbed and drop all the wood onto his driveway. And get yourself a cool 3,200 marks if the flatbed is completely full. If you follow the darts, when you get a call for someone that needs their septic tank emptied out or poop collected, each of the houses are easily distinguishable by the fact that there's always some guy sitting out here drinking and smoking continuously till the end of time. Hello there. Jos ite toa el tu rieta. That's my attempt at reading his shirt. So there he goes. He doesn't have the creepy eyes that follow you, but he's definitely seen some shit in his life. Look at those eyes. Okay. Anyways, so what you're going to want to do is when you bring your poop truck on over, you're going to look for the septic tank here and lift this guy up. If it's filled to the brim like this, that means there's a 1,200 mark reward waiting for you if you bring the truck over and suck up all the septic tank and all that poop and pee and all that good stuff. Wreck 1 can be found on the north side of the map, right next to the large radio tower. It's in a little shack over next to it in a big green field. This is the highest paying wreck that you can bring in for 4,500 marks. The second wreck can be found at the crossroads between the railroad and the dirt road on the southern side of the map. This wreck will go for around 3,000 marks. Wreck 3 can be found on the western side of the dirt rally car track on the southwestern side of the map. This wreck will go for around 2,200 marks. Alright folks, that's all the locations in My Summer Car. If I've missed any locations or if you have any questions about the game, please go ahead and leave your questions in the comments section below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next episode. Thanks so much.